At our Ignite conference, we made some bold commitments on the roadmap for OneDrive for Business, and today we're delivering on those commitments. This is a new era for OneDrive for Business with our next-gen sync client, major mobile app enhancements for iOS and Android, a completely redesigned browser experience and new sharing capabilities, as well as more new IT controls for managing external sharing. So let's start with sync. We heard your feedback on the sync experience loud and clear. We're delivering the next-gen sync client for both PC and Mac, and it's based on the proven OneDrive consumer sync client run by millions every day. Let's take a quick look at the client. So here I have all my files and folders laid out for me in my sync folder. And what I can actually do if I click into a particular folder, I can actually go and choose the folders that I want to take offline. So in this case, I can check or uncheck the relevant folders, and so I can manage the local disk space available. Also, this is device specific, which means I can have different configurations for different devices that have different constraints around local storage. And of course, you get the same experience on the Mac. In addition to that, we're removing the 20,000 file count limit and we'll support files up to 10 gig in size. Now let's take a look at the enhancements to our mobile apps. Starting with Android, we've now included offline support. So as you can see, as I scroll down in my files, I can actually select individual files and you'll see the little parachute icon. Tap on that and those files are now available to me when I'm offline. So for iOS users, we've also got some cool new stuff. Firstly, being able to trigger common actions on a specific file is easier than ever. So all I have to do, as I go to the file that I want to work with, hold my finger down and you'll now see common actions that I can take on that file. The other thing that we've included for the iOS update is the ability to add annotations to PDF files. So let's go in and have a look at one of these files. I can go into the editing or annotation mode and I can put drawing on there as well. So let's say I wanted to highlight this particular section or I want to go and put in some highlighting of text. There we are there. And as I make those changes, they'll upload those changes to OneDrive for Business for me. So a great way to review and apply changes to PDF files all directly within the iOS app. Next, for the browser, we've got a whole new experience. First, files and folders are now easy to work with, and I can toggle between a list or a tile view, so I can visualize those very easily. We've also got common actions available to us. So as I right-click, I can go into details, I get the rich preview of that particular file, I can see who I've actually shared it with, as well as the recent activity or history for that particular file. We've also made some significant changes to the Get a Link function. So when I go into Get a Link, I can actually now pick a restricted link. I can pick a link that says I only want people to be able to edit or view if they're part of my organization. And if I want to, I can actually go in and set an expiration date for that particular link. So now protecting my files is easier than ever. Beyond all the user enhancements, we've also added new IT controls for external sharing. First, an admin can turn external sharing permissions on or off for specific users versus the current tenant-wide setting we have today. And we're previewing the ability for admins to specify which external domains users are allowed or prevented from sharing with. So here's the admin console that we'll be providing, and the ability, first of all, allowing users to invite and share with authenticated external users. And then what I want to be able to do is control the domains. And in this case, I'm going to not allow people to share with northwind.com and microsoft.com because they're regarded as my competitors. Or I can go in and I can actually say, only allow sharing for specific domains. So it's really easy for me to have those level of controls on which domains our users can share with. So that's just a quick taste of the fantastic new capabilities for OneDrive for Business, and you can get started today. You can learn more about the specific features by tuning in to the other demos from the demo bench. Our engineering leads will go deeper on the areas that I showed you today. As you can see, it's an exciting time for OneDrive for Business. Thanks for watching.